In Chapter 1 of this series, we made some brass jackets out of discarded 22 long rifle casings using the Blackmon jacket swaging die. In Chapter 2, we're going to move on to the next step in the process of swaging bullets, making lead cores. When swaging bullets, cores are used as the raw material that's eventually shaped into a projectile either with or without a jacket. The core making process is also the single most important step of bullet swaging, as it's used to control the weight and the size of the bullet, both of which are essential to consistency and accuracy. There are two different ways of making cores, including cutting them from lead wire and casting them with a special mold. I don't have access to lead wire, so I opted to cast my cores instead. The mold you see here was custom made for this purpose using a standard Lee Precision blank. As you can see, it takes a 6-cavity handle set and includes a sprue cutter, making it simple to use. Below each cavity is an adjustment screw. These are used to control the size of the cores, allowing for a wide variety of different bullet types. The first thing we're going to do is drain the leftover wheel weight alloy from the melting pot and replace it with pure lead. Unlike conventional cast bullets, cores have to be cast from pure lead for several reasons. For starters, lead's extremely soft, which makes the swaging process much easier and eliminates the chance of damaging or breaking dies, which can occur with harder alloys. Working with pure lead also ensures the cores consistently weigh the same, so long as their volume doesn't change. With our pure lead melted, we can now begin casting. As you can see, the process is identical to casting any other bullet. We simply fill the cavities, cut the sprues, and dump the cores. Since we want our cores nice and soft, we won't be quenching them at all. Instead, we'll let them air cool. Cores also don't have to be filled out 100% completely all the time, since the swaging process will compress them into nearly perfect cylinders. Now that we've got a good number of cores cast up, we can move on to the next stage, weighing. I've decided to produce a standard 55 grain 223 bullet. For this to work, we need to determine how much our jackets weigh so we can customize our cores to make up the remainder. 22 long rifle casings can actually differ in weight from brand to brand by as much as several grains, so I've gone ahead and sorted these accordingly and selected Winchesters for this batch of bullets. Next we'll weigh a few jackets. As you can see, these are coming in between 9.9 and 10 grains. For simplicity of mathematics, we'll call it 10. That means we need to produce a core weighing 45 grains to make up the difference and bring us to 55. For this, we're going to be using the core swage die set. As you can see, it consists of three different components, including the punch, die, and ejector. Basically, a raw, cast core is placed into the die and then forced against the punch. This causes pressure to build up until lead begins to compress and eventually bleed off through the holes you see on the sides of the die. This serves to bring it down to the correct volume and weight. This also serves to smooth out any areas of the core that hadn't quite filled out right, leaving us with a much nicer looking core. Installing this die set in the Blackmon press is simple, if a little counterintuitive. Whereas most swaging systems move the punch into the die, the Blackmon system actually works in reverse by moving the die towards the punch. This allows the swager to adjust the punch depth rather than the die position when determining how much lead to remove. Now we'll select a core, apply a little bit of swaging lube, and insert it into the die, lining it up with the punch. As the two meet, we'll lower the press handle and begin swaging the core down to size. As you can see, the excess lead is exiting the die, where we can collect and recast it later. Finally, we'll raise the swage press handle again and remove the newly swaged core. Using our scale, we can see it weighs in at exactly 45 grains. The first time you do this, it'll probably take several tries before you get the weight right. However, once the settings are dialed in, they can be repeated over and over without adjustment. Now that we know the punch depth is set correctly, we can go ahead and produce hundreds of cores in very little time. Let's do a couple more. Here's a handful of the cores I made following this process. They're still pretty greasy, but as you can see, they look much more uniform and consistent than when we first cast them. In our next video, we'll seat the cores into our jackets and then commence point forming.